round of 16 spot at stake here, as Gerasimenko, who won the spin of the coin, has chosen to begin here to Jannis Seckeren. You touched on in the knockup there, expecting a pretty free flow, very entertaining matchup here between these two Fraser. Get your thoughts here, elaborate on that, these first few points that we see.
When I looked at the draw and saw these two are facing off, I thought one word, rallies, because they're very open styles. Gerasimenko drifts a bit further back than Safian, who stays close to mid-distance. But they're both very consistent players. They like blocking, both of them. They like turning a block into a counter. They like the loop-to-loop rallies too, so I thought the styles would complement each other from an entertainment standpoint.
3-2.
Not interested in that though there, Gerasimenko, as he fires it into the body. He's beaten a Chinese national team player, Gerasimenko. And I had the pleasure of commentating it. He beat Liu Dingshou, former world junior champion.
Beat him in the contender event in Slovenia, one of the two last November. Because Fraser, you've been all over those contender stops as well.
Seeing
them.
It's been amazing to see players come up and through. And
well, it's the pyramid, isn't it, in world table tennis? And the contender, all the levels, the tiers are important. Just see Gerasimenko struggle to handle the pace there. But yeah, all the tiers, we're right at the towards the top of the pyramid, if you like, this week. But all the tiers are important. We talk about that day one to world number one journey, but playing opportunities for these elite athletes as well. Opportunities to build a ranking up, which is what they've both been doing.
We're both spearheading their national teams, respectively. Number one in their countries. I mean, Indian table tennis, we know, is on the rise. We've seen the Ultimate Table Tennis League. We know the strength and depth that's been built, the funding that's coming into play, how they're strengthening the national centres and moving abroad right now. I've always seen, not just the way who he represents, but how he plays, I've always seen Gerasimenko as a bit of a lone ranger. Comes to these tournaments, minds his own business, but on the table, he's a fighter.
Similar things that can be said of Jannis Seckeren, the way he competes. Leads by two here, the second towel break. It's likely, we think, likely to be a tight matchup here in the best of five. This first game set the tone, put the pressure on the opponent. Oh,
six,
yeah,
seven.
Through. Of the table.
It's really hard to hit a ball past Safian. Reads it again very well.
7-4.
His anticipation is top notch, actually. Pendulum serve. Kirill Gerasimenko on the back foot goes for a Truls Morrigard like slap. Not far off. Backhands away from the table. Beautiful play, slowing it down with spin. He's back there, so he doesn't want to play with too much power.
Please play.
Arcs it back, and Safian tightened up and got a bit stiff there. Block long, clutch play, 8-all now with the serves. Fizzing through the balls.
Oh.
It always became like, it was like you were watching the same shot on repeat in the way it was being blocked back.
Well, it's as you said, I mean, we expected lots of open rallies here because they do a lot of things actually similarly to our high standard, don't they?
Seriously do.
So they're looking here to try and outwit the others. kind of effect neutralising each other in key aspects of the matchup.
Oh, the net there played such an important role in securing that point. Wasimenko looked in trouble. Sathyana played well, got him moving around, and then, ooh, tough pill to swallow there for the Indian. He looks towards the table tennis gods and asks why. And a good punch received, comes straight through it.
Gerasimenko with the opener.
I think it was the Belgium Open 2014 or 15 where Sathyan broke through.
Come on. Love two.
And in the last six, seven years, what he's done is just paved the way for these new Indians coming through. Manav Thakkar in the men's game.
Oh, there's a load of quality Indian talent. I'm going to be very interested to see them commentating the Commonwealth Games after this as well. I've been chatting to members of the Indian team. Sathyan is going to be key to them. He was key. I was there 4 years ago in the Gold Coast in Australia. Of course, that's continental level, but it's important to them. They've got huge numbers of players coming through.
It's a tournament they know they can win.
Let.
Just could do with just pushing his numbers up a bit here, Yannis Sacre. And he's not doing badly behind service. But Gerasimenko there. Three quarters of points won so far in the service.
Sathyan.
2-4.
He's getting fired up because he is actually quite an animated player. He's quiet right now. That first game in the Infinity Arena, both players making their debut here.
Trying to get their table tennis to do the talking.
Mm-hmm.
Make the noise. Ooh, a bit more pace there.
3-4.
From Gerasimenko. Sneaky pace.
He's got one of my favourite forehands, the way he comes through it with the waist. Being well coached.
Come on. 5-3.
Sathyan seems more of a disciplined player in terms of having a plan. And I think the style of Gerasimenko epitomises his mentality. It's quite free-flowing.
Four, six.
Very natural player. Which kind of, in a way, goes against what I said about him being well-coached, but... In the basics, I'm talking about. Good player from Sathyan. Although he should have probably tried to play it a bit more down the line than into the racket of Gerasimenko.
8-4.
Nice little run being put together here by Yannis Sekeren. Six of the last 8 points to open up this 4-point cushion. In the second.
Nine, four. Let's.
transferring well again through that ball, but I mean, I think Sathyan's playing it a little bit too much to Gerasimenko. Mm. Go for a finisher down the line, you know? Playing it a little bit softly.
Yeah, I was about to say, actually, it's Gerasimenko here, just playing with a little bit more punch, a little more pace, just a touch. Six, nine. Reserved about that. Crushes that away.
Go on. Change the backhand serve because, in fact, he wants to open up, and that's what we see a lot of. I'm not saying that Gerasimenko is a backhand dominant player, I don't think he is, but if you're confident on the backhand, like backhand dominant players are, such as Jorgic and Ovcharov, you'll see them doing more backhand serves, and that's the reason. It sets up the backhand. Good change from Gerasimenko. We might see a timeout soon if
he doesn't take this point here. Yeah, I'm with you, Fraser, on that. Service back here, trying to close the second.
9-8.
Indeed.
Does Ramon here think about it? Yeah, come here on. It is. Timeout.
Come on.
Well, it's best of five. I mean, it can be sometimes sound a bit obvious to say this, but I mean, Yannis Seckerini having led handily in the second, and he's down, of course, in what is, keep saying, in essence, a tight match. You feel he's got to close this summer. He's got to get back to one each.
9-8.
2-0. Having been ahead in this game for so long, that would be a tough one to take.
9-4.
Great flick. Gets what he wants with the touch. Timeout diffused. And now he will have the serves at 9-0. This would definitely be a blow guy, wouldn't it? Yeah.
Yeah.
Very hard one to recover. Mentally and physically. I mean, he's done it with slow shots too, spinny shots. Sathyan is freezing. He needs to turn around and play that forehand from the backhand in this ball.
Look at this run. Taking him to game point. Six of the last eight.
Come on, Zadie, come on. 10-4.
That's Yannis Seckerin now who saves the game point. Critical period of this round of 32.
Joe! 11-10.
Poor service. Sathyan will be looking back at this match, questioning what decisions he made in these moments, these tight moments. Sathyan right now looks like a man to me who wants this a bit too much, in a way. He's overthinking it. Can't afford to think about the outcome in a game of margins where each decision has to be made with such clarity of thought.
No! 11-1!
Ringing out around the Infinity Arena, the delight of Yannis Seckerin pushing his way there towards a pivotal point. It could be. Saved two game points now, one of his own. Got him.
13-11, game to Ganesha.
Massive moment for Yannis Seckerin, who was in real danger there of going two down. Wow, but he levels this. Intriguing encounter with Kirill Gerasimenko now, one each.
Third game, Gerasimenko to serve. Love four. One love.
Oh. important third game, effectively becomes a best of three. A yellow card handed out here as well. Just now for Emma Sekerin.
Let's one all.
Oh my goodness!
One,
well, I have to see that on the replay. I think Sathyan did just get his bat on it before it touched the table, but that is a one in a million moment. Top edge. Did you get his racket on it before it touches? Just.
Two, one.
Just. He nearly didn't make contact with it.
Reflecting back on that previous point, I think that's going to make an entry onto our social media channels. Of course, reminder, at WTT, Instagram, Facebook, at WTT Global on the Twitter.
Well, these two now are, I think they've gone through the stage of feeling each other out on the table, having not played in quite a few years, 3 years exactly. But I think now they're kind of mutually, you know, getting to the mental stage where like, yeah, we're both going to fight here. We're not holding back anymore. Seems like that at least, doesn't it?
Slow burner.
Yeah, definitely.
Nothing to prize them apart here at the first towel break of the third. And that little dink where he just about got there from Yannis Sekerin, I'm sure... we'll be making some noise on social media. Remember, get in touch, the event hashtags as well.
Oh,
invite your comments on that.
Four, three. One.
Slow
three,
spin and
five.
Kirill finding himself. Just stepping back and passive. That had a lot less topspin on the ball than he thought, and I'm surprised there that it just dropped down on underneath the table, actually. But like, Sathyan had greased it.
Four, five.
Yeah, the yellow card happening because I think Sathyan was taking a bit too much time.
Go!
Although I will be watching it back.
Six, four.
Tomahawk.
Go!
Into the body.
7-4.
Simple combination. Short topspin to forehand and
please don't touch.
Seems like Kirill is slightly being a bit passive there on the receive. Could have come through that ball with a flick.
Five-7.
Well, we showed in the second game that he's a man who fights when he's down, Kirill Gerasimenko. He's almost better with his back against the wall. You don't want to be in that position if you can help it there. Especially a man who's number one in his sport in a country with over a billion people.
Oh.
6-7.
Yeah. The dig that he needed there as he reduces the gap. Gerasimenko and Yannis Sekerin there was all over him. Doesn't come
thought
out
that
with
was
anything.
It there.
Yeah, there we go.
Thought he might have seen a hand switch, but no.
Not to be.
Go on.
Seen a tweener already this competition. Snatched that one a little bit too much. Even with the punch, you want to have a little bit more dwell time on the backhand. Took it too much in front of him. And he did that because of the Chiquita flick that was played before from Sathyan.
Go! 9-6.
Just a little bit more solid, isn't he, right now, Jannes Sekkarinen. He's pushing, actually, short game. I think it's improved as well as it's gone on. Grissomeka's not really getting the opportunities there quickly out of the short.
7-9.
He's got a nice touch play. Sathyan. A lot of the Indians have nice hands, as they do in badminton as well. Good feeling. Flexible wrists.
Oh!
7-10.
There and waiting.
Instinctive yet intentional in a sense. Stuck his bat out. He knew there was a lot of pace coming in on the ball. Didn't have to draw back.
And it's that feeling as well, Fraser, as well. You talk about the soft hands, but there as well, it's the hands.
And the bat angle.
Yeah.
A few things there in a split second.
That's wild from Garasimenko. The attempted third ball attack, and Jannes Sekkarinen, having been a game down, now is 2-1 up here.
Fourth game, Jannes Sekkarinen to serve. Love
four. Grasimenko fighting for survival. This round of 32 match here.
One, love.
Come on, Sati, indeed. Good start there from the Indian.
One,
oh. Grasimenko is lightning quick on his feet, isn't he? Using the balls at the front. Barely ever flat-footed. He makes good angles too.
1-2.
But Safian's timing is that little bit more early, which is why Grasimenko has a little bit less time. You can see him naturally drifting back as well.
2-0.
Which again, Safian might from time to time be able to get away with, but against that slightly higher level opponent from Safian, someone like maybe a Lin Win Ru wouldn't be able to do that.
2-3.
That's a beautiful receive. Double bounce. It looked like it was going half long. Sathyan thought so as well. That's what you advise as a touch. Second one on the white line.
3-4.
Prodigiously talented, easy on the ball at the table. Garasimenko with the slight advantage in this fourth. Oh, he just couldn't quite get there. The tape did for him. Those pushing exchanges again. Tried to counter topspin. Long way back to be going for that, though, for Garasimenko. Jannes Sekkarinen very close to the table in the end.
Yeah, you'll barely ever see Jannes Sekkarinen lobbing. In fact, I can't remember the last time I saw him lob. Refuses to give up distance.
6-4.
Thank you.
Try it, Jack. Come on. One, boom.
Six, five.
Can you hit a counter any better?
Not sure. Pretty high level here from Yanis Sekeren, considering Gerasimenko is in that corner. Much to work with to find the clean winner, but he did so.
Stop
and then that. And that's
six,
like
off.
Computer game table tennis, that. Corner to corner. Easy does it from the Indian.
Didn't need to manoeuvre Gerasimenko out wide with anything more than just a simple backhand block. Let the forehand do the talking in the end. He's very good at moving his opponents around, and as a shorter player, you need to be good at that. Otherwise, it's going to happen to you.
Charlie! Oh,
6-7.
Yeah, it popped, didn't it? Popped from the Yanis Sekeren. Talk about the importance here of the pushing. That one wasn't good enough and it got him in trouble. Gerasimenko able to get in and over the table to finish it.
Ooh,
straight through. I think he wouldn't mind a timeout here, but of course they used it at the end of the second. And he went on to win. Gerasimenko's still got his.
6-10.
Real possibilities of a 15 deciding game, as we thought might be the case here. Gerasimenko is very close to achieving it. Two very evenly matched players. 4 game points against Yanis Sekeren.
7-10. Yanis
Sekeren in the first to crack there, and this one is going all the way. Gerasimenko's turn to fight back. Final game decided to come for this round of 16 spot here in Budapest.
One block.
Into the middle, towards the shoulder of Yanis Sekeren from Gerasimenko to begin this final game.
One, all.
Should be a big win for Gerasimenko. World ranking wise, a bigger one than for Safian.
Well, it popped up, but he'd also kind of checked with side spin there. So Yanis Sekeren, of course, he's not going to get into the table. It's always difficult to do that, but he's not the tallest player there. So he's reaching forward and then having to adjust to his right.
Johnny, come on.
Two, all.
He's had some good wins. Let's not forget that as well coming into this encounter.
Well, you made that point right at the outset.
You know, Zhang Wujin in 2019, Falk the year before, Benedict Duda, Assar, Walther, Kenta, you know.
Pings it away. I mean, that's on the line.
That final one there, he bent his wrist and arced around it a little bit. You'll be able to see it here. That's how he made the angle, and that's how he got it away from the racket. Look at that.
Scorcher.
Turning into a nail biter, but they're still playing freely, which is great to see from an entertainment standpoint. Oh, that's
amazing. Amazing turnaround there from Gerasimenko.
That backhand away from the table that's allowed him to get back into a lot of rallies. Starts with a fish and then comes in with the actual ball over the top. Could he be two up with the serve at the change of ends? Can be. Just caresses it down the line into the backhand of Safian, who actually stepped in off the serve, which is unusual. Don't want to be too close. Especially after a long serve. You can't do a long serve and stay up to the table. Strange decision making there from the Indian.
5-4.
But we know about Safian, and this is one thing. It's irreplaceable sometimes. The fight. You can see it in his eyes.
5-4.
Excellent point from Yanis Ekeren. Just enough angle.
Time out.
And the time out, which Gerasimenko has kept in the bank. He'll use it now. These are the sorts of matches that can really change careers in terms of rankings, the points on offer this week in this inaugural WTT Champions event.
Five.
Rankings at these two are at right now. It's massive, these next few moments.
No!
You can feel it in the air, can't you? You can feel they both sense the opportunity because they're not playing against a Ma Wong or a Liang Jinkun or a Silent Assassin in the first round. They're up against a player of similar decoration, so it's... can it even make it more tense?
Yeah, it's the way the draws worked out. We talked about it, some of these brutal draws for the top seeds where they play someone, you know, top five seed, play someone just outside the top 10.
Let's.
But here, got two five, pretty similarly seven. Ranked players. And in terms of the points on offer this week here on the Infinity Arena, this is huge for both of them.
Early timing point. Didn't actually go back away from the table, and that was the key thing there. If Gerasimenko can stay up, he actually has bigger shots than Safian. See if he can stay disciplined with that distance again. See what serve he tries to use to set it up.
7
and he does it again. Nice count. It's not too big. Just enough.
Got a slightly greater weight of shot, as you've pointed out, but also it's just fractionally closer to the table, staying closer to the table there, Gerasimenko.
7-8.
Nice turnaround for Gerasimenko here since the timeout.
He's gone from two big shots and on the receive there, just turning it into touch play. Gerasimenko, you could tell, wanted to attack but got impatient there. And chose the wrong one to loop.
Flicks that back hard at the Indian.
Very frustrated at himself. Blown 4 points in a row. What a timeout, and more importantly, what execution after it. Set up. Could have been a winner. Probably should have been.
Sure. 8-10.
Yeah, not quite enough. Anna Sakharam wasn't far away. He's talked about adding to his game here, about adding a little bit more. He was trying to do it there.
Didn't come through it enough with the weight transfer, and that's why it clipped the top of the net.
Two match points against him here in favour of Gerasimenko.
Back to the tomahawk.
He was trying to push his way into the round of 16, but not yet for Gerasimenko.
What a way to save match point. What a fight.
This has certainly lived up to the billing. Just as tight as we expected it to be. Second match point here.
He's done it.
Huge win for Kirill Gerasimenko here on the Infinity Arena.
Well, what a match it's been here.
That was, it was tit for tat, really, with Sethyan Yanasekharin. It could have gone either way, but it goes the way of Gerasimenko in the end. 11-9 in the decider.
Fantasztikus mérkőzés volt, és nagyon-nagyon szoros is. Nyilvánszokon múlott a továbbítás, de végül 11-9-re a döntőszettet Gerasimenko hozta. Így aztán a kazak fiú ott van, legjobb 16 között.